Hi, good to see you. I'm Laura Williamson, your host. This is Bare Fitness. Thank you for joining me again today. It's good to see you as always. Well, today's show, actually, we're going to talk to some of America's finest. We're going to talk to some Girl Scouts today, and they're going to tell us what it is to be a Girl Scout, what it means, and what it means for the future. But before we go there, I'd like to take a moment of silence for today. Today's date is actually September the 11th, 9/11. As it would be. So I'd like to take 30 seconds first of silence before we start the show, and then we can talk to our very special guest. So stay with me. All right, even though it's been 11 years, we have not forgotten, and I don't think any of us can forget. However, I wanted to focus on the positive today and think about what tomorrow will bring for us. And in doing so, I thought it would be an excellent idea to bring some Girl Scouts in and talk to them about what the future holds for them and what they aspire to and what it could possibly mean for you day to day. So at any rate, I'm gonna start with our guest there to my left, and they're going to introduce themselves. So ladies, welcome. It's good to have you here today. Thank you for joining me. And if you will, I'd like to start from my left and just work your way around and introduce yourselves, if you would please, to the viewers at home.
My name's Casey Cook, and I'm an Ambassador Girl Scout.
My name's Molly McGowan, and I'm also an Ambassador Girl Scout.
My name is Caitlin Fitzmaurice, and I'm an Ambassador Girl Scout.
And Casey, Molly, Caitlin, thank you again. I'm so happy to have you here today. And I'm going to be the first person to say, I wanted to be a Girl Scout. And I did not get the opportunity to be a Girl Scout, but I did have my big, thick, green textbook at the time. And I remember it, and I used to go through it, and I used to see all the badges. So we're going to go through it one step at a time. For all those girls out there who maybe are Girl Scouts, but for those who actually especially want to be Girl Scouts. So I'm going to start from my left once again. So you tell me, tell us, how did you get started? Why did you get started? One step at a time. Start from the beginning.
I started Girl Scouts in kindergarten. I went to school and came home with a flyer, and my mom was a Girl Scout, and I always heard her stories. So I was like, Mom, I want to be one. So we signed up, and she became my troop leader, and the rest is kind of history.
Okay, was Mom a troop leader before you signed
up? No, she joined when I signed up. She became the troop leader for my troop.
Okay, so Mom was a Girl Scout.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, all right. So let's move on. Let's start with, tell us, Molly.
Yeah.
Okay, so Molly, how did you start?
So I started in kindergarten just like Casey. My mom was also my troop leader as a Daisy, but she was also my sister's troop leader. So my sisters were Girl Scouts when I was a Girl Scout as well. So when we were young, it was a lot of fun that we started together. And since then, I've stayed a Girl Scout since I was in kindergarten. And when I got into high school, I got very, very involved, and here I am today.
Okay, now you said Daisy. Now, is there a difference between one and the other? Does it vary by age? How exactly does that work?
A Daisy's a kindergartner and a first grader.
Okay.
And then a Brownie's a first grader, a second grader. And then a junior's a third, a fourth, and a fifth grader. And then cadets is sixth, seventh, and eighth. Mm-hmm. And then it goes up front to senior till you're a sophomore in high school.
Mm-hmm.
And then the rest of your high school career, you're an ambassador.
Okay, so it ranges in age and grade.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, is there a special ceremony do you get pinned? What exactly happens when you graduate from one to the other?
We have this ceremony called a bridging ceremony.
Mm-hmm.
And you start at one side of the bridge and you walk to the other side where Girl Scouts who had just crossed the bridge are there to greet you. And like, it's a symbolic ceremony, like crossing the bridge and having your friends there to be with you and like show you the new way of Girl Scouting.
Now you say your friends. Now, are all your friends Girl Scouts, or that's any friend that you have who happens to be there to support you when you're bridging or when you bridge?
Well, in Girl Scouts, we like to think of every other Girl Scout as our friend.
Mm-hmm.
So Girl Scouts who have just bridged before you are there to greet you at the other side of the bridge.
Oh, that's so nice.
Yeah.
Okay, Caitlin. Now tell us, how did you get started?
I started Girl Scouts in first grade as a brownie. And I didn't really know much about it when I started. But I got into it with my troop, and I started doing a bunch of activities with them, and I really liked it, so I stayed with it.
Now, what made you join? Did someone convince you to join, or did you see someone in a uniform or have a friend, and you said, you know what, I think I want to give that a try?
Yeah, I had some friends that were in it.
Okay. So. Oh, very nice. Okay, now, let's, okay, so I'm going to stick with you, Caitlin, if you wouldn't mind. So tell me, what is being a Girl Scout, what does that mean to you? What does it mean overall? And
It's a huge part of my life, and I do a bunch of different activities that all can connect back to Girl Scouts.
Wow. So question, okay, so I'm going to work my way back around, so I'll come to Molly now. So now with you, Molly, I'm thinking about, and I noticed that you all have these beautiful, are they pins, badges, or both? I'm just trying to get an understanding for what you're wearing. You have sashes on, you have vests. And so I assume that you can wear one or the other. It doesn't matter. Is that correct?
Yeah.
Okay. What do your pins? What do your pins mean? What does everything mean that I'm looking at currently?
So these. This is our troop number.
Okay.
And then this one says that we're Girl Scouts in the United States of America. And this one is we are a member of the Eastern Massachusetts Council, which is where we are right now. And then all of these are our year pins. So the blue ones for 1 year, Daisy, and greens for Brownie, and so on. And then these is what level you are. So this is the senior pin. This is the senior rainbow. So I have to move up to the ambassador rainbow.
Okay.
And then this one says that we were on the CEO advisory committee, which is a thing in Massachusetts that we help Ruth Bramson, who's our CEO, with planning activities and what girls are interested in. And then this one, we have these. We have journeys. And they're kind of like patches, but they're greater than that. There are three journeys per age level. And this one is the Girltopia journey, where we like create a vision for a world that we want to live in. And then this one's the Silver Award, which is the second highest honor in Girl Scouting. And then these ones are just regular patches.
Okay, so create a vision for the world you want to live in. Casey. What world, what kind of world do you want to live in? What does that mean to you?
To me, it means one where everyone has the chance to be the person they want to be and live in the world they want to live in. So it's different to everyone. But the Girltopia one, which I did as well, focuses on like equal rights in terms of gender equality and things like that. So it's very interesting to learn about different places in the world that, you know, women don't have the opportunity to do this or whatever the case could be. So,
so empowerment. Of girls. Girl power? Am I wrong on that one?
No.
I'm okay with that. But, okay, I want to go back. Girltopia. Okay, you have to explain the Girltopia because I like the way it sounds. I've never heard it, but I would love an explanation.
I can't really explain where it comes from because that's something that Girl Scouts of the United States of America named it. But to me, in the way the book kind of defines it, is some place where it's a utopia for girls, and where every girl has like their own perfect world.
So I'm assuming your world is what you make it. Whatever you want to do, whatever you want to be, you aspire to do or be that.
Yeah.
Is that wrong?
No.
Okay. So then let's go from here. I'm gonna touch on this very briefly, and I have to do this. I'm gonna talk about the cookies for a minute. Just for a minute. I know that this is a health and wellness show. I get that, but please bear with me. I got to go here for a minute. Now, let's talk about the cookies and the way that recipes. Now, I noticed that there are certain cookies that are very popular. Personally, I'm a Caramel Delights girl and a shortbread cookie. I'm being honest. However, everyone has a favorite, and I noticed a certain time of year, there are 2, 3, 4 stacks. People will buy a lot of them. But I noticed some changes recently. I noticed that some of the cookies, some of the flavors, there are different flavors. Am I crazy? Did I imagine that? I noticed that some things have changed.
No.
Now, is there, I mean, does that, it doesn't happen often, I don't think, or was there a reason for the change, or did someone submit a recipe? How exactly does that happen as far as recipes are concerned? How do you determine what's popular and what isn't?
Well, in Girl Scouts, there are 2 different bakers you can choose from, and each council makes the choice for that area. So here we have ABC Bakers, and so they have one type of some cookies, and then the other one's Little Brownie, and they have different cookies. There are a few though that are exactly the same, just with different names.
Okay.
And then every once in a while, ABC will decide, oh, you know, we're going to swap out shout outs for a new cookie or whatever it could be. But usually shortbreads, the two peanut butters, Thin Mints, and Caramel Delights don't really change because they're the fan favorites.
Yeah, I'd say so. And I have to, I don't think I've ever seen anyone buy just one box of cookies. Is there something in particular you're putting in the cookies so people feel like they have to buy multiple boxes of cookies? It doesn't matter how much they cost. No one cares about the price. It's just you have to buy as many boxes as you can, I notice. So, I mean, there has to be something that you're doing specifically. I'm being honest, because I'm one of them. I will buy the shortbreads and the caramel. I'm all over that. And there's nowhere that I go that someone isn't selling Girl Scout cookies. I mean, pretty much you're taking over at this point, yeah? I think so. I think Girltopia, I think that's definitely happening. So what I'd like to know is, what does tomorrow mean? What does tomorrow hold? Okay, once again, we're going to go around. I want to know what your plans are for the future. I mean, will you recruit other young ladies to also be a Girl Scout? Like, I mean, I assume that it's been a source of empowerment for you, and basically it's, I mean, so what's your plan? Tell me about you.
Yeah, I definitely do recruit. I tell all my friends about it, and a lot of them are like, that's so cool, I wish I did that. Or they're like, I'll get my little sister to do it or whatever. But for me and tomorrow, I just decided on my Gold Award project, which is the highest award a Girl Scout can earn. It's like the equivalent to the Boy Scout Eagle Scout. Mm-hmm. So I'm in the process of working on that to get it approved by Girl Scouts. And then I'm starting to look at colleges, which is freaking me out, but it's exciting. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Caitlin, what's your plan?
Right now I'm working on the Girl Scout Gold Award, as well as Casey. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And my project is to educate younger children about marine life.
Wow. Okay. Wow. As an educator or as a like a marine biologist, like what exactly did you specifically?
Well, I'm running a program at my local town library with different activities for kids to come and do.
Oh, okay. Very nice. All right. How about you?
I'm also working on my Girl Scout Gold Award project. Mine is to bring imaginative play toys into Children's Hospital Boston.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah, so I'm very excited about that. And I have fundraisers coming up, and for the distant future is to hopefully become a troop leader and have all of my children as Girl Scouts.
Well, I think what I want to do is we're going to take a small break, I think. I want to talk about what it means to be a troop leader, because I understand it goes age to age, grade to grade, but where does it stop, or is it as long as you want it to be? And it seems that it goes. So if we could, I'd like to get more explanation for that. But before we go there, let's take a break. We'll be here. We're going to talk about this a little more, and we're going to find out some more about lovely ladies today. So we'll be back soon.
It started out like a totally normal day.
I love you.
I mean, I guess I was a little sweaty, and I was definitely sore. I thought I had gas. Turns out, I was having a heart attack. Heart disease is the number one killer of American women. So now I take care of my heart, and I tell the women in my life to do the same.
Sounds great, by the way.
That's nice, sweetie, but that's not my heart. That is. Find out more from the American Heart Association at goredforwomen.org.
Okay, welcome back. Okay, now, we're going to go back to Molly. Okay, being a troop leader. Now, how exactly does that happen? How does that work? Is that just a natural process that comes over time as you get a little older? Or what are the steps if you want to be a troop leader? Can you just become a troop leader, though you've never been a Girl Scout? Or do you have to pretty much go through some of the steps beforehand?
You can definitely become a troop leader or volunteer if you haven't been a Girl Scout before. If you like have a daughter who wants to be in Girl Scouts, or a niece. Mm-hmm. Or even you're just very interested in the organization, we are always looking for troop leaders.
Mm-hmm.
And
okay.
So if you want to just become a troop leader, you're absolutely able to do that. And then there are people who are going to be like us, who go through the ranks of Girl Scouts and stay in it for life and become a troop leader.
Okay, that sounds pretty cool. Now, Chelsea Clinton. Let's talk about that for a minute. Did you guys get to meet her?
Yeah. Yes.
Now how? Okay. So now we get into the good stuff. Okay. Now, how was this experience for you? Meeting Chelsea, because I was at the gala. Now this is your anniversary, right? 100 years. Is that correct?
Yep.
Okay. Now we're gonna work our way around again. Okay. Now, How was she really?
She's actually really nice and sweet. One of the things I really liked about her was that she wore heels on one foot and the other she broke her foot and was in a boot, and she showed up anyways and didn't want help from anyone. And she is what a lot of girls aspire to be, because she really has it all. She's brilliant and has earned her own merit and isn't afraid to ask and do what she wants. So, and I loved meeting her and asking her questions. Mm-hmm.
Now, Caitlin, what was your experience?
I thought it was really fun to meet her. Mm-hmm. We went in and we each got our picture taken with her. Mm-hmm. And then after all of the pictures were taken, we kind of formed a circle around her. And we just took turns asking questions.
Oh, that's so nice. Okay, Molly, tell us all about it.
It was so cool. It was the coolest experience ever, getting to meet Chelsea Clinton. Like, being able to talk to her. She was a Girl Scout when she lived in the White House.
Right.
Like, it's so cool to hear her stories of when she was a brownie.
Mm-hmm.
And then she's so attentive and listens to what Girl Scouts is about today.
Mm-hmm.
And just a really well-rounded person, and getting our pictures taken with her and chatting with her like we knew her forever was really cool.
Now, do any of you ladies volunteer your time? Is that part of being a Girl Scout too? Do you go to any of the kitchens around the city, or, I mean, as you will be teaching and are teaching children, I mean, do you do anything voluntary? Do you donate? I mean, what exactly do you do? I mean, and feel free to answer freely here. Whoever jumps in first is perfectly fine for me.
As a Girl Scout, like, committee, like the whole Girl Scouts of Eastern Massachusetts, we donate the leftover cookies to one of the Boston food pantries,
mm-hmm.
to give to, like, people, to, like, homeless people or people who can't afford food.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a really big thing. And personally, I do a lot of work with kids with special needs and in the hospital, and I'm on the board for Leukemia and Lymphoma Foundation.
Mm-hmm. And how about the rest of you ladies?
Well, in addition to the cookies, when people are buying cookies, they have the option to do cookies for a cause.
Mm-hmm.
And those either go to local food pantries, or a lot of times they get sent overseas to soldiers,
mm-hmm.
To bring a piece of home. So then Girl Scouts has a big event at Hanscom Air Force Base, or it's just something great to see them, mm-hmm. go to people that just want a little piece of home. But I work with a lot of younger kids in my town.
Mm-hmm.
I do a lot of things in terms of environmental stuff. I'm in a club at my school, and Reading Girl Scouts, which is the town I'm from, they do a lot with our town food pantry,
mm-hmm.
and do a lot of drives at, like, every event our town will do for Girl Scouts. There'll be a drive and people will bring canned goods and send them off to the people that need them.
And Caitlin, how about yourself?
Well, I also do cookies for a cause,
mm-hmm.
and I donate my cookies to the soldiers overseas.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm a volunteer at my town library.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm a teen tutor for the homework club.
Okay, very nice.
I tutor children in grades 4 and up.
Okay, I think what we didn't do is we didn't give our viewers any idea of what your age or ages are and what grades you're in. So how old are you, and what year are you, or what grade are you in right now?
I'm 16, almost 17, mm-hmm. and I'm a junior in high school.
Junior in high school.
Mm-hmm.
That means prom. Okay. Are you ready do you get anything for sewing? Do you do anything for that? Actually costuming or anything of that
no,
sort?
No, I'm not that skilled with my sewing. I barely get my badges on my vest. I would love to think I'm that talented, but I'm not.
Okay, so what about the rest of you ladies?
I'm 16 and I'll be 17 in 14 days. Very exciting.
Oh, very exciting.
And I'm a junior in high school.
Are you driving?
Well. No.
No. Are you not allowed to drive?
No, I could. I just don't want to.
Okay. Yeah, it's kind of hard to drive. Yeah. Okay, now how about
yourself? I'm 17,
okay.
And I'm a senior in high school.
Oh, nice. So you went to prom.
Mm-hmm.
You've already had prom.
Yep.
Okay. You got one more coming. Excellent.
We do a dinner dance at our school.
Oh, very nice.
Yeah.
Very nice. Wow. Okay, so you guys are definitely leading the way. You're more than leading the way. You're trailblazing at this point. I think that's kind of awesome. Okay, so my question, I'm going to throw out a Miss America question. If you could change the world, no. All right, so I'm taking that back because that's just been done. But no, I mean, in all seriousness, this is very impressive. And, you know, what comes to mind for me in particular is I think of in my mind, I remember seeing a sign and it says, accomplish her. And I remember seeing that sign, and it has a beautiful little girl on it. And this is what I hear, this is what I see when I look at all three of you. So what I'm thinking to myself, I mean, Do you think it made a difference for you? I mean, if you hadn't have been a Girl Scout, do you, I mean, it's definitely, I mean, I think it's been more than a positive influence. I mean, but again, and I know it's a little repetitive, but I mean, I can't help to be a little proud myself, to be quite frank with you. I mean, but in what ways would you say it's probably helped you?
When I tell a lot of people about my Girl Scout experiences, I define it as one of the best decisions I've made is to continue being a Girl Scout. It's taught me leadership beyond anything else I've done. Mm-hmm. I don't know where I would have gotten to be such a leader, and through the different experiences I've had, whether it's been traveling alone or working with other people, it's taught me how to be a good team player. And in terms of leadership and independence, I traveled for the first time by myself when I was 13 to Wyoming through Girl Scouts, and it was one of the best experiences of my life.
Wow. Molly, what about you?
My experience through Girl Scouts has been very similar to Casey's, and Girl Scouts has totally made me the person who I am today. Without Girl Scouts, I don't know where I would be. It's given me the confidence to do more community service, to be a better person in the community, a better student. Girl Scouts totally made me who I am today.
And Caitlin?
Girl Scouts has changed my life through the opportunities that it's given me. Mm-hmm. And I've gotten to do so many things that I wouldn't have done if I wasn't a Girl Scout.
What would you ladies recommend for someone who isn't a Girl Scout, they're not quite familiar, they don't know anything about who you are, what you do, and hopefully this helps a little bit with the information. But I mean, what would you recommend them to do if they want to get started, or if they're on the fence, they're thinking about it, they're not sure, they're kind of indifferent at this point. But if you had to recommend someone to get started, what would you say to them? Where would they start? Where would they go? What would they do?
I would say around this time there are a lot of recruitment and registration events. Mm-hmm. So try to find it through that, and just to sign up. Worst case, you don't like it and you choose not to do it. Mm-hmm. But the benefits outweigh any risks, because there really aren't any. There mm-hmm. aren't any negatives mm-hmm. to deciding you don't like something.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right, you're up.
Okay. I think for someone who is not a Girl Scout but would like to be a Girl Scout, or wants to explore the opportunities to be a Girl Scout, their best bet would be to try out one of our different pathways. We have series that they could do a program for 6 weeks to 6 months to 2 years, mm-hmm. that they're with one group of people, whether it's like a hiking group, a camping group, mm-hmm. or a travel group. I'm currently in the travel series, which is a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. And or they could join the troops, mm-hmm. which they could be in the troop for their entire like life, mm-hmm. until they graduate from high school. Or they could do like programs if they wanted to go to do a STEM program, which is science, technology, engineering, and math. We have conferences, we have clubs, we have all the different things revolving around that. Mm-hmm. So whatever their interest is, they can find it in Girl Scouts mm-hmm. and find a way to make it work for them.
Mm-hmm. And Caitlin?
I agree with a lot of what Molly said. Mm-hmm. Girl Scouts pretty much covers everything, mm-hmm. no matter what you're interested in.
Mm-hmm. Now, can I go online to look for some of the, mm-hmm. the recruitment and the recruiting that goes on? I mean, should I assume that every town has one, or the closest town to mine might have one, and I should look them up? Is that the easiest way to go about it?
Most towns do, and you can usually find everything on the Girl Scouts of Eastern Massachusetts website. Mm-hmm. They're really good with trying to get girls to join, and Yeah.
Now, how often are you ladies recruiting? I mean, do you have appointments, or is it just one big meeting? I mean, how does this happen? Is it a room full of girls who come in with parents, and you kind of just talk to them and walk them through what they can expect and how things typically work? How does something like this typically happen? I mean, is it like a college search? You go to like, say, maybe BU or something, and you go and you sit in one of the big theaters, and you have multiple professors, and people come talk to you. I mean, how does that happen?
Well, you can register to Girl Scouts. The fiscal year for Girl Scouts starts on October 1st, mm-hmm. and it lasts until the next September 30th, September 29th. September 31st.
Okay, so we're coming into a recruitment period right now, technically mm-hmm. speaking. Mm-hmm. So again, if someone was interested, and what's the youngest age you can start?
Five.
The youngest age is 5, mm-hmm. and then is it that you graduate once you finish high school, you kind of graduated, you're done, but you have the choice to come back and still volunteer your time? Mm-hmm. Is that typically how it works?
Mm-hmm. Yes, or you can get a lifetime membership, which you usually get when you graduate from high school, and you can have it for your whole life and forever be a Girl Scout.
Wow. Okay, forever be a Girl Scout. Well, I'm just thinking. I mean, I'm just noticing some of the pictures. I mean, do you ever go on trips? I mean, you go on camping trips, I would assume, yeah? Do you ever do other types of trips? I mean, what are some of the events that you actually do, or what can a girl look forward to, if, I mean, as far as going places and maybe even and encountering? I don't know, I mean, do you do whitewater rafting? I mean,
yeah.
Oh, you do that too?
Yeah. Yeah.
I was really kidding.
I went with my troop when I was in fourth grade, whitewater rafting. But some of the other types of things you can do everything from going and learning to do science or math to whitewater rafting to having a tea party to traveling somewhere, either with your troop or on your own. A couple years ago, my troop went to Martha's Vineyard mm-hmm. for a weekend. And then I've gone on two destinations, which are independent traveling opportunities for girls that are usually in middle school and high school, mm-hmm. And different girls from around the world, the country, that Girl Scouts go on these. I went to Wyoming when I was 13 for 8 days,
wow.
and Atlanta in 2011 mm-hmm. when I was 15 for 14 days. And there's all destinations like that all over the world. Most of them take place in the summer, but they're incredible.
Well, wow, ladies, this has been a lot. But wait, you guys have an event coming up, I believe, very important event. On October the 29th, the Leading Women Awards at the Sheraton Hotel, and you're going to actually honor six remarkable role models. It's your 21st annual Leading Women Awards, and I assume this is something you definitely, obviously you do every year. I assume that you choose women who are actually making strides. I mean, I think this is everyone, but I have Beth Boland, Joanna Lau, Juliette Mayers, Marie Turley, Susan Wyndham, Bannister, and then we see some other people here. I mean, I see Bill Fine, who's the president and general manager at WCBTV, who's gonna be there too. He's, I believe, the leading man in supporting role, if I'm reading this correctly. So I think this is coming up, but I think this has been awesome talking to you ladies. So I think we're gonna take a break. I have to work out. Had I been thinking, I should have asked you ladies to work out with me. That's what I should have done. Would I get a badge for that? Well, I mean, you know. But at any rate, but ladies, thank you so much for joining me. So we're gonna take a mini break, and I think I'm going to work out. But it's been a pleasure. Thank you so much for coming. This is exciting. I think I'm a little old to be a Girl Scout at this point, but
never. You can always be an adult Girl Scout.
That's right. I could be a troop. I could be a troop leader, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. There's something to think about. But okay, from these ladies, they're telling you heard it here. So don't go away. Come back. We're gonna work out, and then we also have some more pictures from New York, from Ground Zero, that I'd like you to take a look at. But more importantly, come back, we're gonna work out, and we'll see you soon.
Now, some action from the courts. Billie Jean King renewing her rivalry with arthritis. First set, furious volley, and right to the net for a winner. Beautiful forehand there. Arthritis, stunned. And here, match point. Billie Jean with the ace, taking it in straight sets. Afterwards, a jubilant Billie Jean King.
Tennis is a weapon for me with arthritis. There's nothing like it for me to hit a ball, run to the ball, anytime. Any court, I'm ready. Let's go.
What's your weapon against arthritis? Find out at fightarthritispain.org.
It's Timothy Green's first day at school.
What's in there? He's about to fall over.
Anything he might need. There's a box of tissues on the bottom. It's a Band-Aids. There's a whole first aid kit, actually.
Mom, I can handle it from here.
You don't have to be perfect.
Have a great day.
It's too much pressure.
Have the day you have.
To be a perfect parent.
There are two people in the world who want you more than anything. They'll make some mistakes, but they will love you more than you can ever imagine.
There are thousands of children in foster care who will take you just as you are.
Workout. Here we go. I have my tube today. Today's going to be a tube workout. So if you don't have one of these, I recommend that you grab one. You know, I always mention what I think you should have at home. So today we'll do a circuit with our tube, and it's all tube all the time right now. So I think today's show was a good one, but we are going to start with bicep curls. So it was good to have the Girl Scouts in today, and I hope you learned a little something. Hopefully you'll join and be inspired today. But to start, what you want to do is put your foot on the tube and stretch your arm. You should feel a little tension on your tube before you move. And before I forget, you know, I always have a small disclaimer. You should have a doctor's note before you work out with me today if you have never worked out. If you have any physical ailments, disabilities, incapabilities, anything at all that you feel may hinder you, I ask that you A, check with a doctor. If it hurts you, leave it out, take your time, keep water very close to you, and keep a towel next to you. Don't work past the pain. If something hurts, stop. Work up to a point, do the best you can, and that's all you can do, and try to do better next time around. All right, so take your time, take it slow, go steady, whatever music you have, because I always try to have a little music with me, so I have a little bit of music, and just start going, okay? So we're gonna work through this circuit style, 6 exercises. We'll get it done in, I don't know, maybe 20, 25 minutes, okay? So stand on the tube, arm by your side, and you're gonna curl. All right, so you find a tension that's good for you, that you can actually work with, and you start moving. All right, and that's it. So we're going for about 12 reps here, and then you're gonna change sides, but you're gonna keep moving, all right, and curl. Try not to let your wrist slip backward. Try to keep it long, forward, and strong. And hold. Now, we're gonna go into the next exercise, which is a squat, and you're gonna stand on the tube. Feet are a little bit apart. Press the heels into the floor. Tube is at the arch of the feet, and you're gonna squat down, hands by your shoulders, and you're gonna stand. Stand, okay? So I think on this one, you do as many as you can. You can do 10, you can do 12, or you can do 15. All right, but the goal would be, obviously, progression. And hold, all right? So the next one, I think we're gonna do triceps. So this is how we'll do this. You're gonna wrap one hand, bring the other hand behind you, and then you're gonna take the other hand and wrap. Now you're gonna get a good grip. I'm gonna turn sideways so you can see this, and you're gonna straighten, bend, straighten, all right? And that's gonna work tricep for you. Same thing here, same rule applies. One more, and done. Let's go to the other side. All right. Hand is here. You're gonna wrap the hand around, elbow down, and straighten. Straighten. Straighten, keep the shoulder back and down. Push it away. Five more, and four. Two more, last time, and done. All right, now let's do shoulders. All right, so once again, we're gonna step on the tube, we're gonna do total body. All right, and again, lift, lift, lift. Not too bad today. I would say today's workout is a moderate one. And again, you can move this tube to where you need it. So it's a resistance that you can work with. One more, and done. Change sides. Make sure you're stepping on it, and pull, and pull. Almost done. Keep it going. One more time. Ah, done. All right, now, let's work a little back. All right, now wrap both hands. All right, you see that? Straight, thumbs under, fingers away. You're gonna circle around, and so you wrap the hands. All right, now from here, I'm gonna turn back so you can see you will open and you will close. All right, once again, you adjust the tube to where you can actually work. Open and close. Open, close. Open, keep going. Two more. One more. And done. All right, very good. Now, here's another one. We're gonna work legs again. All right, so this is good for toning the bottom. So you wanna bring your feet together. You wanna step right on, right at the arch. Then you're gonna cross your hands. And then you're gonna stand up nice and tall. Make sure your posture is good. Pull your shoulders back and down. Pull your tailbone to the floor. Make sure your abs are engaged. And you're gonna take a walk with me. So here we go, out and in. What you wanna make sure is you don't wanna hip hike. This is wrong, all right? You just wanna push it out and go the other way. If you're doing it right, you'll feel the burn. You won't have to go far. And I feel the burn. One more. And done. All right. So from here, we start all over again. We go into our curl, biceps, and let's curl. Again, you choose the tension. Today is about you choosing what you want to do, how you want to work, and then you can progress yourself from there. So keep it up, you're doing awesome. One more time. And done. All right, now let's do the other side. You probably didn't know the tube could do this much, did you? All right, step one, keep moving. Nine, 10, 11, one more, and done. All right, now it's time for the squat. Grab the other handle, step in, step out, push out, and actually, I'm gonna move my feet in just a little bit. Hands behind me, I'm gonna squat into it, and I'm gonna stand. Spread my feet apart just a little bit, and keep going. All right. Remember, you're sitting on the couch. Maybe you don't have a tube. Do it anyway. Just move. You always want to move. It's better than doing nothing, you know? Keep going. Five, four, three, two, one more time. And awesome, good. All right, step it off. Triceps. All right, here we go again. Meeting together, let's try this. Thumbs, wrap, wrap. Oh, I didn't do it like that last time, did I? Oh wait, here we go, one hand first, and then wrap the back hand. So let's go there again. Okay, wrap the one hand, bring it overhead, then turn the arm around, hand around, and then wrap. Okay, now we're ready. Now one, here we go. Straighten, straighten, straighten. And the other hand gives you resistance. See how I pull down here? There goes some of your resistance, okay? One more time. And done. All right, the other side. I'm gonna do it again. Repetition is always key on these things. Go back, wrap the other hand, elbow by your side, and push. Push. Very good. Four, five, six, seven, two more, one more, and done. All right, that was triceps. Now let's do shoulders. All right, move it where you want it. I think I want it here. And lift, and lift, and push. Now if your shoulder hurts you, don't do this exercise. Not a good idea. Okay, you should have a little shoulder strength, and you need to choose a tube that's good for you. So if you're not sure which one is good for you, which color is good for you, try to get some help in whatever store you're in. Okay, each color tube represents a different amount of resistance for you, or a level of difficulty, if you will. All right, let's do the other side, and reach. And reach. Five, six, eight. Keep it going. Two more. Last one. And done. All right, scapular retraction. Hands. Wrap. Pull. Okay. Right in front of the shoulders. Pull. Sideways view, pull. Back view, pull. See how I squeeze the shoulder blades together? Take it to the side. Two more. One more. And done. All right, now. Legs again. I'm always excited to do legs and push-ups. Okay, cross the hands. Okay, I'm gonna take a walk to the right, to the right. Okay, go the other way. And hold. Ooh, is that burning yet? Toning all that, trimming all that. Okay, biceps again. All right, you got it now. You know what you're doing. I know you do. And just curl. One more. Okay, one extra. I didn't tell the complete truth there. I decided to give you an extra one. I slipped it in. All right, here we go. Curl. Oh, wait. That's a little easy. Trying to keep it honest. Two more. And done. All right, legs again. All right. Okay, hands here. We're almost done, believe it or not. We worked our way through all this. Oh, did I tell you we're doing 15 of these, by the way? One more, and done. All right, triceps, and push. Yep, two,
your heart and soul is what I came for.
Two more. One more. And done. Okay, now let's go to the other side.
Take off your coat. Don't you know?
And push. All right, so I've come to the end of my time today, and it was good to see you as usual. So you stick with the workout, you know what to do, and we'll see you next time, okay? And we're gonna go to a break, but actually we're just done. We're not even going to a break. We're done today, we've done everything, and I'll see you next time, okay? So again, 9/11, and keeping in mind all the people who are heroes and lost lives for us. So we'll see you next time around. Just keep working out. Just keep going.
My life is full of statistics. Thing is, I could have dropped out of school and become one myself, but I didn't, because I had people that believed in me. Here's another statistic. 7,000 students drop out every school day. That's one every 26 seconds. It's time that students know that we believe in them.
Inspire a student and share your message of support at boostup.org.
Yeah, it is. All right, so we're almost done. Keep going. I hope you worked through the commercial. I did. So we only have a couple minutes left. And, oh. Almost done. Stick with me. We just took a small break. I tricked you. I fooled you. But honestly, we're almost done. So it's good to see you. And please look at my images from the new tower that's being built in New York, commemorating 9/11. All right. Scapular retraction, and after this, the lateral walk in case I don't see you, okay? Scapular retract. Four, five, keep going. Six, okay. Stretching your way out to the break. Keep going.
I always get.
Keep going.
What I aim for. And your heart and soul is what I came for. Whatever love wants, love again. Take off your.
Alright, stretching our way out of here. Again, good to see you. This is Bear Fitness, and I'm Laura, your host. See you next time.
quick time play.